What do you like to eat when you tailgate?
I'd eat chili cheese dogs, barbecue, chicken wings.
I like barbecue wings. Wings, chips, and usually pop.
I wouldn't drink water.
Hot dogs, hamburgers, nachos, and cheese.
And for dessert, cheesecake.
Chocolate?
Hey, whoa.
I love this time of year, Glenn. Fall is in the air, and I can't wait to go to the game and cheer on my favorite team.
Hey, and you know what goes hand in hand with sports? Food. Can't have one without the other.
That's right, and I really like to go to the game and tailgate with some great food.
Hey, and tailgating doesn't have to be just chips and processed food. There's ways to be creative with food that's fun and healthy, too.
And today, we're going to teach you how to cook like a champion at your tailgate. We're going to be making some traditional foods, but with some healthy options that are easy and fun to prepare.
Hey, all right, so let's go tackle some cooking and score a touchdown on this week's Kids Can Cook.
Oh, nice play on words, Glenn. Nice play.
Waking up to sunshine on a beautiful day. Brush my teeth, comb my hair, and I'm on my way. But wait, I need a healthy breakfast before I go.
Okay, today, my young scientists, we're going to be preparing food for our tailgating party.
Tailgating? Well, wait, before you get too excited, we need to do a little research because we have to make sure that our tailgating food doesn't ruin our healthy diet.
That's right. With a little bit of knowledge, we'll see that we can still have good-tasting food that's still good for us, even when we're tailgating. We want to watch and make sure that we're looking for food that has low fat and sodium because that can prevent heart disease. And we want to watch our calories because that can prevent overweight, obesity, and diabetes.
Right.
Now, does anybody know what this is? Ever seen one of these before?
What is it, Joe?
I see those on like the back of a bag for like food and stuff.
Right. What are they called? Does anybody know? Nathan?
A food chart?
A food chart's very close, Joe.
A nutrition label.
Very good. So here they are, and they tell you a lot about the food that's in that package.
And we're going to start with calories.
Okay, so we're going to look especially today at the calories, the fat, the sodium, and the protein. Now, calories. Calories tell us how many calories are in that food. Now, just to live, you guys need about 1,800 calories. If you eat more food and more calories than that, and you have two things you can do. You can either be more active and burn it off, or your body will store it as fat. And we all know that stored fat can lead to obesity and diabetes.
Now, next is fat. We actually do need fat to be healthy.
That's right, but there's two kinds of fat. There's saturated fat and unsaturated fat. Saturated fat is bad fat. It's mostly animal fat, and it's that white, gooey, ooey stuff that clogs up our arteries. Unsaturated fat is mostly from vegetables. You know, and what two things did we always say that we use? What kind of good fat? Do you remember what kind of oils? Jayla.
Omega-3
fatty acids are in those oils, that's correct.
Olive oil and
canola oil.
Yeah.
Very good. Olive oil and canola oil.
Now, next up is sodium.
Sodium is next
on our list. Right.
Okay, sodium is a mineral. Now, we need minerals, but we don't need very much sodium. It's in a lot of processed foods, so we have to be very careful because some processed foods have a lot of sodium.
Now, who can think of something that has sodium that we use every day?
Baking soda?
We were thinking of salt. Sodium is salt, okay?
That's right.
And if we have a lot of sodium, it can make us very thirsty. We take in too much sodium, and that can be bad for our heart.
And that's because it raises our blood pressure.
Okay, next on our nutrition label is protein.
Now, you all know we need protein, right? We need the amino acids in protein for almost everything in our body to make us healthy, to grow our hair, to grow, to energize our body. So we need protein. But we usually have way too much in our diet. It should be only a fourth of the plate or about the size of a deck of cards.
Okay, guys, now here is your project assignment for today, okay? How many of you like to have hot dogs when you grill out and tailgate? Okay, very good. What we're going to do is we're going to give you three nutrition food labels. We want you to get your heads together, look them over, and you tell us which one you think is the healthiest to have on our tailgating party.
All right, which did you find is the healthiest? Did you all work together and find one?
Yeah. Well,
who has the healthiest label?
I do.
And why is that, Joe?
Because mine only has a total of 62 calories and only 1 gram of fat.
And how much is the sodium?
Only 455.
Which is a little bit high, but
yeah.
But Nathan, do you have well, you're in the middle or the worst?
The worst.
And how much sodium was in yours?
1,570 milligrams.
And you about had a middle brand, right?
Yep.
Joey, yours. Guess what kind of hot dogs those are? You don't know, do you? But they're low fat, pork, beef, and turkey hot dogs. But the low fat, so those are the ones we're going to buy. Reading labels is a part of being healthy. It's a habit that we should all do and look at the labels all the time for those kind of things.
We have planned for you another field trip.
Yay.
Uh-huh.
So put on those teleport goggles because we're going to...
Danny Catullo has agreed to open up his shop and tell us all about protein and healthy cuts of meat. And ready?
One, two, three!
Whoa, how did we get here?
Hey guys, I'm Danny Catullo and this is my butcher shop. Have you ever been to a butcher shop before?
No.
What? No? You've never been to a butcher shop? Well, where do you think you get your beef for your cheeseburgers?
Cow.
But who cuts up the cow?
You.
I do, the butcher. Sounds like a pretty cool job, right?
Yep.
So I get to learn the different cuts of meat to see which is better for cheeseburgers or which is better for roast, for like roast beef sandwiches, which I happen to love too. Okay, so cheeseburgers, one of my favorites. Which part of the cow does it come from?
The chuck.
The chuck? Yeah, but which part of the actual cow? Let's pretend I'm the cow, okay? Okay, I don't think this is funny at all.
I do.
Do you agree with me? Don't I look like a skinny cow?
Yeah.
Okay, no. I'm a very skinny cow. Which part of me would be the chuck? The short. Is it the goggles? Are you guys meat scientists?
Yes.
Yes, no, I knew there was something fishy. All right, so we're gonna be doing burger, and it's the chuck, and it's the front shoulder, right?
Right.
Okay, why do we use the front shoulder?
Because it's juicy.
Because it's juicy, yes, because we want our burgers to be nice and juicy, right? We wanna taste the flavor. All right, so I'm gonna show you the different types of beef, okay? What the difference between like the shoulder roast is and the rump roast. I know, you know what? You meat scientists have something going on and I'm unsure about it, but I'm gonna show you the different cuts because I like you. I bet you can't pick out which one's the fat. Which one? Point. Exactly. Now, there are some fat in these two roasts here too. And I brought two different things so we could show you the difference between the chuck, like the shoulder that we talked about, and then this is a block rump roast where we get ground round. So the rump is going to be much leaner than the chuck roast. Now, just because it's leaner doesn't mean it has as much flavor. You guys talked about you want a like nice, juicy burger, right? So we want our roast to have a little bit of fat on the inside of the roast. That's called marbling fat. Can I show you this? Do you see the marbling on the back of this roast? The little veins inside there?
Yeah.
Well, those aren't actually veins. Those are actually little strings of fat that cook up really nice in the roast and actually disappear and dissipate as the roast is either cooking to make you like roast beef with potatoes at home, like with gravy, or if you want to grind it up and make cheeseburger out of it. This is good fat.
How does it disappear?
You know what? That's actually a great question. because of it being on the inside and not like the outside fat, like this fat right here just wants to stay. So as it just like, it'll just keep on condensing, and it'll actually be like that bad fat in your body. Whereas this fat inside the roast, the marbling fat, it just wants to allow the meat to be very tender. So because it's inside of all that red stuff, the actual meat and all those proteins, it'll actually break down and be very flavorful and good for you. Sounds good?
Yeah.
All right. Does anybody know how much fat an average ground round should have? Guess.
10%.
10%? Even less. Guess.
5.
Even less.
2%.
2 to 3%. That's correct. 2 to 3% ground round would have. If I was going to grind this for burger and we wanted it extra lean, I would take all that fat off the outside and we'd be able to grill it up. But I don't think that it has as much flavor as the chuck. This is our guy. Now, how much fat is in this chuck roast? On average, what do you think? Guess.
10.
10%. That's exactly right. 90% lean ground chuck makes the best burger. All right, guys. So we're going to eat some burgers. You getting excited?
Yeah.
Why don't you guys take a look around? I'm gonna get the machine ready, the grinder in the patty machine, and we're gonna form some perfect cheeseburgers for later. Sound good?
Yeah. My little meat scientist. You have fun back there? Yeah.
You guys real life butchers now too?
Yeah.
Yes. Now you can say you've been to a butcher shop. You learn how to take a roast, grind it up, and make burgers just like a real butcher does. But I want you guys to make some burgers yourself. Can you be able to do that?
Absolutely.
So I ground up some chuck for you. I got some packages. And then I want you to experiment. Do whatever you want. Be your little scientist selves that you guys are. And remember the guy that was the best looking cow in your life. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Skinny cow. Remember that. Yeah. All right. So I need you to put your goggles back on so you're able to transport. All right. All right. On the count of three, we're going to say holy cow. You ready? One, two, three.
Holy cow.
Beautiful day. I bet the kids will be here soon, don't you think?
I'll bet. There they are.
Oh, hi. Where have you been?
Catullo.
What are you bringing us?
Meat.
Some lean cuts, I bet.
Yeah.
All right. Glenn's going to take those over by the grill and get them ready. Now, can you hand me that hand sanitizer? Come on down here. And each of you, I'm going to put a little of this in your hand. And do we have any water and soap out here?
No.
So we have to make sure our hands are clean before we start cooking, right? Make sure you rub in between your fingers and get them totally clean. I like the smell. Do you like the smell?
Yeah.
Could you give us each piece of paper towel there, Joe? There you go. And as we wipe our hands, Glenn's coming back in here, I'm sure, in a minute, and you're gonna start mixing up the hamburger while I go get some more things out of the car, okay?